Yo, what's up, everyone? Welcome back. In this video today, we're going to be talking about some interesting developments with Season 4 Reloaded. This includes leaks and rumors, so stay tuned for that at the halfway point of this video. First things first, I'd like to talk about the second shotgun that made its way into the game. If you thought the MX Guardian was the only overpowered shotgun to drop yesterday with Season 4 Reloaded, you are sorely mistaken. There is a brand new attachment called the Corvus Torch. This is exactly what you'd think it is. We got ourselves an underbarrel shotgun that fires dragon's breath. Why? Because we can. That's why. I think people got the impression from my video yesterday that I'm not really a big fan of the way the shotguns have been for Season 4 Reloaded. But it's quite the contrary. I quite enjoy them. I think it's so much fun to just be running around with these weird, wacky weapons. And I hope they continue to add weird, wacky weapons. But even I can say, yeah, it's a little bit powerful when we're talking about the day and age of balancing, when balancing is such a big focus and a big focal point. Specifically, when you look at something like Warzone, for example, you don't want a shotgun that's just completely shredding, but hey, here we are, and it definitely is. I want to talk about the Corvus Torch, though, because there is a challenge in order to unlock this, that challenge requiring you to use the standard undermounted shotgun to get 15 point blank kills, and then when you're done with that, you'll have access to the Corvus Torch with the Dragon's Breath. Now, this is one of those situations that I can say definitively, this shotgun not only gains more damage, and it also gains more power after the fact that you fire a shell, because the incendiary damage will just continuously burn the enemy until they die. Realistically, the only time you're gonna see a hit marker is when there's a little bit of range between you and the enemy, and even then, there's still the possibility of getting one-shot kills. I cannot believe how powerful the undermounted shotgun is in this game, and it actually makes me happy. It's not a direct comparison, but do y'all remember back in the day, the FAL masterkey combination? If you don't, let me remind you. If you use the FAL in the original MW2 with the masterkey, you basically got unlimited range with the undermounted shotgun. And it did a lot of damage, don't get me wrong. This was fixed. It took a while, but it was fixed. And after the fact that that happened, they started looking at all the other shotguns in the game, including the Model 1887s. But this kind of reminds me of a bygone era. It reminds me of the time where you just had shotguns that were just absolutely crazy. Shotguns that will stop people in an instant, and more importantly, shotguns that act like shotguns. I understand that it shouldn't always be the case, especially when we're looking at something that's fully automatic, but at the end of the day, you really do have to make that choice. Do you want a shotgun that acts like a shotgun, or do you want something that fires marshmallows? But I can definitely understand the frustration. You're not wrong. It's crazy. It gets a little bit annoying, and it can get frustrating at times. And, you know, it's only a matter of time before we end up seeing something done about it. I'm sure they're going to make changes accordingly, but I guess we'll see. Now, as for the Corvus Torch, I can definitely say that this is like a backup weapon. No longer do you need to worry about those close quarters engagements. Say you're using a tactical rifle or a marksman rifle with the ability to equip a shotgun to it. My gosh, it's like having a shotgun as your primary weapon without all the flashy attachments. This thing is right up there with all the primary shotguns that can have 5 attachments on it. It's actually crazy. And if you go into the gunsmith and you fine tune it to give you extra range, it just gets even wilder. Having that bit of incendiary burn after the initial shell, that gives you a little bit of time to navigate away from the enemy and let the burning take care of the work, or you could fire another shot and get it done even quicker. For the sake of my gameplay, I tried to utilize just the shotgun itself. I wanted to see if it could be used as a primary, and yeah, easily can be used as a primary. Once again, it competes with some of the primary shotguns even just as an attachment on an AR. So having the best of both worlds is actually really nice. You got your AR for long to medium ranges, and then when you want to go in close quarters or storm a house or go through a specific building that's close, then boom, just go ahead and pull out the shotgun and you're good to go. It should be utilized that way, but if you really wanted to, you could do like I'm doing here and just use it the entire game. Let me know your thoughts down below in the comment section. What do you think of the Corvus Torch? Is this something that wasn't on your radar? Is it on your radar now? Are you going to be going to get it and utilizing it in game? Leave them down below. If you have used it, what do you think of it? All right, so next up, I want to talk about the leaks that came out last night. And first and foremost, one of the biggest leaks is the Modern Warfare 3 reveal. Through data miners, task force leakers, and all the other data miners have discovered that the MW3 reveal is allegedly happening in Season 5. But not only that, it's also going to be happening not in regular Warzone, but in DMZ. And this reveal has a couple of scenes that were found, an intro and an outro, but right now it's just strings of code. There hasn't been any videos found or any images or anything of the sort like that outside of the code that's been found. I'm also curious what this reveal is going to hold for everybody. If y'all remember, when Black Ops Cold War was revealed, we actually had a mission in-game where you can meet Frank Woods in Verdansk, if you remember that. So I don't know if they're going to be going all out like that and having characters from MW3 appear in DMZ where you have to fight them or assist them, or maybe they're going to have something happen in the sense that we start seeing some Shadow Company movements, or maybe there's going to be an entirely different intro that comes together that shows us what we need to do, and then the mission takes place in game, and then after you do the specific tasks or exfil, then we'll end up seeing the actual reveal trailer or some sort of reveal teaser. And if that's coming in Season 5, we are not too far away from that. Now, the big question is, will Season 5 have this happen at the launch? Will it happen in the middle at the mid-season update? Is it going to happen towards the end? We don't really know at this point. Stay tuned to the channel. As soon as we learn more, I'll make sure to keep you all posted right here. Now, speaking of leaks, there were also a couple of leaks for operators. I did discuss this in my video from earlier, but I might as well just bring it up again. Two more celebrity operators have been found within the game files. This includes 21 Savage and Nicki Minaj. Part of me wonders, based on how the developers handle Nicki Minaj, are they going to be bringing the cake to the game or the whole ass bakery? I'm just kind of curious, you know what I'm saying? Either way, those are two celebrity operators that are going to be coming to the game. You know, the real thing about this is, though, I think because they were part of the promotional material when Modern Warfare 2 was first coming out, they were part of like trailers and reveal stuff. I really do think that this was supposed to happen earlier, but maybe they got pushed off to later in the year. I don't know. But I just want to say this, man, because we've been talking about it over the year and just bundle being constantly shoved in our face. I think it's only going to get worse and more eccentric, especially because of Microsoft purchasing Activision Blizzard. There is a really good chance that we start to see Microsoft stuff appear in Call of Duty. And what I mean by that is maybe we'll see a Minecraft skin or some sort of Minecraft crossover, similar to how we saw the Crash Bandicoot crossover. Maybe we'll see a Halo crossover. Imagine an energy sword in Call of Duty taking the place of a blueprint for your sword or something like that. It would be totally likely and definitely possible that we end up seeing stuff like that. But I think at the end of the day, most people that have been waiting since Modern Warfare 2019, they've been saying, hey, we want John Wick. That's the one character that I can say could actually belong in the Call of Duty series, would actually belong in the Call of Duty series and make a lot of sense, because that is what John Wick is all about. And then we could see John Wick's blueprints in the game. Oh my goodness. And you know, there's only a matter of time before that happens as well. But I kind of thought it would happen sooner. I'm surprised it hasn't. Instead, we got the boys, which I guess is, you know, interesting for those that want to take part in that. But hey, anyway, that's all I got to say. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Big thank you for watching this video here today. If you enjoyed, do me a favor, drop a like, subscribe for more, and don't forget to ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. All right, folks, I'll see you on the next one. Peace.